station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground, I'm Isidro Reyna. The science continues aboard the International Space Station. This week, the crew made preparations for the arrival of Astrobees, a self-contained, free-flying robot that will be flying around the station alongside astronauts later this year. Astrobees will help scientists and engineers develop and test technologies for use in zero gravity, help the astronauts do their routine chores, and give flight controllers in Houston additional eyes and ears on the station. The autonomous robot, powered by fans and vision-based navigation, will perform crew monitoring, sampling, logistics management, and accommodate up to 3 investigations. Astrobees builds on the success of Spheres, NASA's first generation free flyer, now aboard the station. Life in microgravity reproduces many effects encountered on Earth by people during prolonged bed stays in intensive care, persons with reduced mobility, or with aging. A better understanding of the relationship between fat cells and blood-producing cells in the bone marrow is key to minimize the impact of decreased activity in our society. Astronauts on the station worked on the Marrow investigation, which looks at the effect of microgravity on the bone marrow. It is believed that microgravity, like long-duration bed rest on Earth, has a negative effect on the bone marrow and the blood cells that are produced in the bone marrow. The extent of this effect and its recovery are of interest to space research and healthcare providers on Earth. This week's question comes from Caitlin of RJO Intermediate School. She wants to know what's the longest amount of time an astronaut or cosmonaut has spent in space. Well, that's a great question, Caitlin. We'll have to take a look back into our archives. The Russian space station Mir endured 15 years in orbit, 3 times its planned lifetime. It hosted scores of crew members, including physician Valery Polyakov, who lived aboard Mir for a single continuous orbit stay of 438 days. He completed his stay in 1995. In comparison, and most recently, retired NASA astronaut and Expedition 46 commander Scott Kelly and his Russian counterpart Mikhail Kornienko spent 340 days aboard the International Space Station. They completed their mission in 2016. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.